Hellos, welcomes back everyone. Anthwulf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. Playing as Theia here, my bounty hunter. And we are here at Outpost Gwent in the Glarus Valley. Where we last left off, we were aiding House Fool and the Empire in securing more friendly relations with House Panteer, who have a mountain hideaway in this region. It seems Darth Victus wishes to hire us to strike a further blow against House Olgo here. We've been given access to this mountain hideaway of House Panteer. Before we head over, we do have this quest. Alderaan belongs to House Fool. That fact is beyond question. Yet House Olgo dares to defy us. Olgo troops have reclaimed a shield generator that once protected Castle Panteer. If reactivated, House Olgo will gain an unacceptable advantage. The Panteer generator must be destroyed. Any available forces are ordered to invade Olgo's nearest supply camp, obtain their access codes, and activate the generator's self-destruct. Coordinates have been provided. We are going to be passing by the House Organa compound that we are going to be assaulting very shortly to locate this Durasteel Duke. We do have this House Olgo supply camp here. The access codes are being held by the Olgo engineers. No, I'm lying, the technicians.
That's gonna leave a mark.
Again, it's down to RNG whether or not the technicians actually have the code on their person, of course. That's 4 out of 5 codes already. Ah, excellent. Got all the access codes we need. down to this shield generator that was protecting Castle Panteer. Let's activate the self-destruct. And our job here is done. Now there is another task being offered to us. In this tent we see a couple of soldiers, not in armor that is familiar to us.
You are not Olgo. There's something you need to know. Come close. I must ask a task of you. And the rivers swarm with Olgo murderers. Tell me. Do you care for Alderaan? Or only for the house you serve?
I know who I am and what I stand for. Other alliances are for convenience.
Then I must trust you as my only hope. I am Serdaris Panteer of the Queen's Guard. Queen Panteer was killed when her transport crashed in this river. Her body was found, but her crown still lies in the water. Find the crown. Evade the army. Take it to Captain Lieber of the Queen's Guard in the mountains. He can be trusted.
I'll do this, but don't tell me I can't wear that fancy hat until I hand it over.
Then I can rest.
We can declare ourselves Queen of Alderaan. I'm sure that will go over swimmingly. Speaking of swimming, let's get ourselves into the river. House Olgo is looking to further legitimize their rule by finding the crown themselves. They're not very good at searching, obviously.
That's gonna leave a mark.
We do have a bonus to defeat 20 of Olgo's forces by crashing the castle, which is tied to finding the crown, which is unusual considering, yes, we are just outside of Castle Panteer, but we're not really going there just yet. I think a few years ago, there was a different bonus mission tied to this quest, because searching for the crown actually happened upriver, just outside of Outpost Gwent, I believe. I think there was a bonus mission to defeat so many of the marine forces searching for a crown. Either way, let us find this mountain hideaway.
Please use all products only as intended. Be well.
Captain, I admire your principles, but it is clear Organa offers no help on what matters most to House Panteer.
You need not try to sell me again on House Thulfixer. But who is this? What do you want with the Queen's Guard, stranger?
I came to sell you a planetary symbol of rulership, slightly used.
You cannot be serious.
If that is genuine, it is worth the lives of every man here. And then some.
Captain, surely this will sway your vaunted neutrality. The Empire and House Thule giving you...
The symbolism does not escape me, Fixer. But that crown has never changed hands without enormous cost. What do you seek in return for the crown? An alliance? Or merely a deal?
You can't put a price on peace, so start handing me credits until I say stop.
But what of House Thule? We require a Panteer alliance and your loyalty to our Empire.
You have neither credits nor crown in your hands, Fixer. We have dealt with mercenary avarice before. We are not without means.
Do not think this independence will go unnoticed by the Empire.
Ignore him. Yours are unlikely hands to have brought the crown home. But on such chances, our future turns.
Yeah. My loyalty to the Empire? You are really, you're really reaching there. Oh, well, we do have a banner belonging to House Panteer. That's right, we haven't really looked at the banners of House Organa yet, have we? If nothing else, we'll look at Panteer and Olgo, since they are who we're mostly dealing with currently. Arguably the most blue-blooded of the noble houses, House Panteer has put more kings and queens on the Alderaan throne than all other families combined. Panteer rulers have been called both patriots and pragmatists. Traditionally, they have been believers in the beauty of Alderaan and patrons of the arts, who nonetheless accept that a lie, a betrayal, or even a dagger can be a sad political necessity. The last uncontested ruler of Alderaan was a proud Panteer queen who had earned the respect, if not always the love, of both friends and adversaries. When Boris Olgo declared himself king, House Panteer immediately challenged his rule. Olgo responded by burning the Panteer estate to the ground and forcing the survivors into hiding, bringing the family low after millennia. While many nobles still see the Panteers as rightful rulers to the Alderaan throne, and many others seek Panteer's blessing to legitimize their own claims to the crown. The Panteers remain suspicious, wondering about the circumstances behind their downfall, and hoping to reclaim lost glory. And of course, House Olgo. The noble House Olgo has a long history in military excellence. The family values discipline and duty above all else, and Olgos pride themselves on forsaking the pampered aristocratic lifestyles the other noble houses have gravitated toward. the Olgo tradition of requiring every member to serve in the military has produced generations of distinguished officers. In recent years, the Olgos became increasingly frustrated with the political stalemate in the Alderaanian Parliament. When the Queen died and House Fool returned from exile with the support of the Empire, General Boloris Olgo pleaded with the collecting nobles to act quickly to push Fool back off the planet. When it became clear the nobles were too fractured to stop what he saw as a second Imperial invasion, Boris Olgo declared himself king and declared war on House Fool. Unfortunately, grabbing the crown forced the hand of the other noble houses, and they have now declared war against Olgo. House Olgo now finds itself beset on all sides, as it struggles to defend the crown and brutally reinstate order on Alderaan, no matter the cost in blood and resources.
Good, you've arrived. Allow me to introduce you to Lord Auron Panteer, nephew of the late Queen Silara Panteer, rightful Queen of Alderaan. Your Lordship, this is the hero I spoke to you about. The one who prevented Ulgo's barbarous attack against your noble house.
It is an honor to meet you. My family owes you a great debt. You will always be welcome in the home of Panteer.
Making problems go away is what I do best.
The elimination of House Ulgo's strike teams has forced them to draw men from their castle guard. The heart of their house lies exposed. Given your exemplary service in defense of House Panteer, Lord Auron has deigned to grant you an opportunity to shape the future of Alderaan.
Boris Ulgo, head of House Ulgo, has betrayed the noble laws of Alderaan and stolen the throne for himself. It will be your task to remove it from him.
Will there be plenty for me to blast?
This is one of the most heavily guarded men on all of Alderaan. You will find no shortage of foes.
Please, do everything within your power to capture Boris Ulgo alive. The people of Alderaan deserve to see that usurper face justice. They deserve...
Begging your pardon, my lord. An urgent matter requires your attention.
Very well. Tell me what's happened.
Captured alive, you will do no such thing. Even in chains, Boris Ulgo is a threat to House Thule's ascendance. He must be killed at all costs.
Isn't it our goal to make Panteer happy?
We will be eliminating House Panteer's greatest enemy. That is their only true concern.
My apologies. Now you understand the gravity of the task being given to you, don't you? Boris Ulgo is at the center of a castle stolen from our house, surrounded by an army of loyal troops. Until now, no one has dared challenge his position.
Thanks for the heads up.
I'll arrange for a special detachment of our elite Queen's Guard to move in behind you and collect the usurper once the job is done. Good luck.
Do not fail us.
You're giving me conflicted orders here.
You have your task. Do not waste time.
You want me to remove Boris Ulgo, but you want him alive, you want him dead.
So you're here now, too. Soon everyone will know that House Panteer wasn't wiped out when House Ulgo invaded and took their castle. Inside, political leaders from House Thul and House Organa stumble over each other to win Panteer's favor and a future crown.
The inner workings of the Alderaan houses put me to sleep.
I am of like mind, believe me. but these details directly inform my job. I am General Gavir, command of the 3rd Battalion, and I'm taking it upon myself to win House Panteer's allegiance to the Empire. House Organa has just launched a surprise attack to liberate Castle Panteer from the occupying Ulgo forces. Thal's leaders were planning a similar campaign, but Organa has beaten us to it. If they succeed, House Panteer will be beholden to Organa.
If your house was too slow to act, you only have yourselves to blame.
I agree. Rather than implore Thal leadership to act, I should do it myself. My men already march on the castle, preparing to decimate the Organan offensive. You could attack before they arrive, ensuring a Thal victory. Wipe out enough Organa forces so that defeat is imminent. Their failure will expose them as weak to Panteer.
That seems simple enough.
If you're up to it, I have another wrinkle. While there, if you could take a large enough bite out of Ulgo, you'll make our cleanup that much easier. But Organa's failure is paramount, so concentrate your effort on their ranks and see me when you're done.
So the good general here doesn't simply want us to wipe out this House Organa offensive. He wants us to blunt their attack enough that when House Ulgo's army turns up, they just seem like the more capable force when they wipe out both House Organa and House Ulgo. But let us be on our way. Both players of the Empire and the Republic both have their own reasons for wishing to remove Boris Ulgo from the Alderaanian throne. Therefore, there is a small chance we'll encounter a player aligned to the Republic as we cross and travel towards Castle Panteer. We've actually picked up the same quest, crushing the castle again. That was the same quest name. Interesting. Oh well. Yeah, why not? We'll do it again. Excuse me. Finally start talking about my dislike for mounted turrets in this game. I will admit I am sometimes deflecting already. I can be easily frustrated. In this game, my pet peeve is to be immobilized, to be stunned for long periods of time. The mounted turret gunners have like a knockback ability for anyone within melee range, and it's just a pain in the butt. With version, I don't want to even say version 1.0, though I suppose it was. Republic Scoundrels and Imperial Operatives, the advanced classes, they have some close quarter abilities where they can stun people. There was an ability that, say, a scoundrel could use, where they would use their scattergun, which is their offhand weapon. to basically shoot someone at point blank range with their scattergun, and it would kind of, there would be an animation to knock them to the ground for about 3-4 seconds, and that got removed, I wouldn't say relatively quickly, but it got removed within a year or so of the game. And that had one of those animations where you couldn't do anything about it because it was a stunning skill, and by the time you'd already seen half of the animation, you couldn't break it using your purge ability. Of course, those abilities were fine when I used them, because I can be a massive hypocrite. But, yeah. What sort of a pet peeve to be incapacitated for a long period. There are still a few abilities in this game. Trying to pick up Jedi Shadows, Sith Assassins, Operatives, and Scoundrels all have abilities to put a character to sleep for up to a minute. But this ability can be broken if that character is attacked. Fighting our way through the Ulgo forces here, as just ahead of us are the House Organa Marine forces that the House Fool General has asked us to deal with.
Thank you. you saying? The smoke clears?
Excellent. Now, we should go back and speak to General Gervier. I'm sure he's going to tell us that he's anticipating or looking forward to the final assault on Castle Panteer and finally deposing of King Boris Ulgo. Of course, by the time we speak to the good general now, all things going well, Boris Ulgo will no longer be sitting on the throne of Alderaan. Excellent. And here we go, inside Castle Panteer. Is the music playing a bit too fast? I think it is. I think it's like on double speed. Just a moment. This music is not correct. And we are heading up to the throne room.
And here we are. It's just as I predicted. A mere tool of the Sith Empire, just like the beasts in House Thule, sent to wrench the throne of Alderaan away from those who rightfully possess it.
Go ahead and waste time blabbing, pal. I get paid by the hour.
Fool! Don't you have any idea what you're trying to do here? what those monsters have put you up to? I was the only one strong enough to do what was necessary. The people of this world deserve a leader who will defend them. I will not surrender this throne for you or for anyone else. Only I can keep it safe. Only I can protect Alderaan.
Enough of your yammering. Die!
I believe I've tolerated your intrusion long enough. Destroy this assassin, men! Defend your king! Defend Alderaan!
We should have really backed out of that conversation, I feel, slightly, but no matter.
Bars, I'm good.
See, sometimes our character says what... Sometimes the lines, you're not sure what lines your character's gonna come out with. Unfortunately, it seems Boris Olgo is protected by an energy shield. Emitters here. But we also have high explosives. Oh dear. Making more friends. All four emitters now destroyed, the shield has dropped.
That's gonna leave a mark.
This is not over. I'm not dead yet. I won't let you win. I won't let the Empire's shadow fall over Alderaan.
Your fellow nobles can decide your fate.
So be it. Let the battlefield change. I will fight to protect Alderaan from the Empire's filth to my last breath, just as I always have.
Area secure, everyone. Looks like the hard part's been taken care of. Boris Olgo in the flesh. Wasn't sure if I'd ever have the pleasure.
Save your mockery, Panteer. If your house were stronger, we wouldn't be here now.
Not very diplomatic for a king.
He'll have plenty of time to remember his manners in our holding cells. Lord Orin, the operation was a success. Boris Olgo is in our custody.
It's finally over. The usurper will finally face justice. You were right, Lord Victus. Our house owes you and House Thule a great debt.
Yes, I must admit, even I am surprised that it was possible to capture the usurper alive. I hadn't expected that particular windfall.
Think nothing of it.
You have delivered Boris Olgo as promised. You have proved House Thule's commitment to the good of Alderaan. So you will have my support.
Will your influence be enough to persuade those misled brothers and cousins of yours who have sided with House Organa?
I'll do my best, but the Organos may not take well to losing. I fear this conflict could be far from over.
After all that I've done, House Thule's position still isn't secure?
It is only a matter of time. You should be satisfied that you had the opportunity to play such a large role. Your work is done for the time being. You can go on about your own business.
House Panteer will never forget what you've done for us. Thank you.
Wonderful. You know, I can't really blame Boris Olgo for the steps he took. I can't blame him for trying to kill us, of course. But now let's get ourselves back over to the mountain hideaway.
I took care of the Organon offensive. The Olgos, too.
Now our army will easily take the castle. This could deliver an alliance with House Panteer. House Thull and the Empire have you to thank.
We just have to settle up, and we're done.
Of course! I've even dipped into my personal commission. May only victory find you. For the glory of the Empire.
Did almost a possible M. Bison impression there. Ah, poor Raul Julia. Level 74.
Please use all products only as intended.
Oh, that's not what I was meant to use. This is what I was meant to use.
Destination?
Get ourselves back over to Outpost Gwent, and I think, oh, bloody hell, this is a good place to take a break once again, but when we come back, we will be assaulting the House Organa compound to find Duke Corwin and claim our bounty for the Great Hunt. But for now, we shall take a break once again. Thank you. Thank you all for joining me here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. As always, feel free to leave a comment if you so wish, and hopefully I'll see you for even more next time. Until then, though, take care. Bye-bye now.